To prepare prawns biryani, first we need to marinate and fry the prawns. So take a plate, add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, add salt as per the requirement, 2 teaspoon of fresh yogurt and squeeze half lime. Now mix all these ingredients together to form a perfect marination. Now add washed and cleaned prawns to the marination. So folks, if you haven't watched our video about how to clean the prawns and to devein it, I will leave the link in the description below. Please go right now and check it and make a good use of it. Once you are done adding the prawns to the marination, now mix it nice and thoroughly. Usually prawn takes less time for marination compared to meat or chicken, thus reducing the preparation time. Let it rest for 30 minutes. Now place a frying pan on the stove, add little oil. Once the oil reaches to the moderate temperature, add the marinated prawns to it. Fry for a minute on both the sides till it curls up to C shape. Make sure not to overcook the prawns as they may turn hard. Once the prawns are properly cooked, transfer it to the bowl and set it aside. So first, let's soak 1 cup of long grain basmati rice in surplus of water for 1 hour, which helps us to get rid of the starch and makes the grain non-sticky. Now, take a cooking pot, add little oil and ghee to it. Once oil and ghee starts heating up, add 2 star anise, 2 cardamom, 4 cloves and 2 cinnamon of 1/2 inch size and fry these spices till it releases its aroma. And now goes 1 finely sliced onion and fry till it turns slight brown and it gets rid of its raw flavor. Now add 2 sliced green chilies. Now add handful of pudina or what we call mint leaves. And now goes 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste and fry till it get rid of its raw flavor and continue the same till it releases its aroma. Now goes 1 teaspoon of fresh curd or yogurt and salt it for a while. Now drain the water and add the soaked rice to the pot and salt it for a while. Meanwhile, we have kept 1 1/2 cup of water to boil. So here the measurements are like, for 1 cup of rice, we have taken 1 1/2 cup of water. Once the water starts bubbling up, add it to the rice and now we are going to cook the rice only 80% and the rest 20% is going to cook in the dum. So make sure not to add excess of water because here we need rice to be bit grainy and not mushy. Now add little salt or as per your requirement and squeeze 1/2 lime to give a bit of acidic texture and add 1/2 teaspoon of sugar and give a quick stir and put the lid on simmer and let it cook for 5 more minutes. Now let's open the lid and check the rice. Wow, look at the rice. It has cooked perfectly and it's fluffy and I can literally sense the warmth of the spices added to it. So now the rice is 80% done and now let's switch off the flame and keep it aside. The last and the final process before layering the biryani is to prepare the masala. Now, place a pan on the stove, add little oil to it. Once the oil starts heating up, add 1 inch 2 cinnamon to it. Once it starts releasing its aroma, add 3 finely sliced onion to it. and add little salt as per the requirement just to quicker the frying process. Now, once the onions are fried and crispy, remove the 3/4 portion of it for garnishing at the end. Now add 2 finely chopped tomatoes and keep on sauteing till it becomes soft and mushy. Now add the grounded grain masala to it. So yeah, here I haven't taught you folks how to prepare the green masala. So to prepare the green masala, take a blender first, add 3 green chilies, 1 dry red chili, 1 bunch of coriander leaves, 1/2 bunch of pudina leaves, 12 garlic flakes, 2 inch ginger, 1 finely chopped onion, 2 teaspoons of fennel seeds, 2 teaspoons of jeera, 2 star anise, 5 cloves, 2 cardamom, 1 piece Marathi mogu. Add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 1 teaspoon of salt. Add little water and make a fine ground paste. Now add the fine grounded green masala to the pan and saute it for a while. Now add 2 teaspoons of ghee just to enhance the flavors within it. Now add 1 bunch of coriander leaves. Once it starts extracting oil from it, add the fried prawns to it. And cook for 2 more minutes. Make sure not to overcook the prawns because it has already been cooked earlier. Once it's done, switch off the flame and now it's time to layer the biryani. Now place the tawa on the stove until it's hot enough. Place the biryani pot on the tawa. Now add a layer of gravy on the bottom. And now add a layer of rice. Now add 1 teaspoon of ghee, 1 teaspoon of rose water, sprinkle some coriander on the top, add some saffron and sprinkle some fried onions on the top and continue the same for the rest of the rice and the gravy. And now put on the lid and let it cook in its steam for 10 more minutes on simmer. And now the yummy and delicious, the mouth-watering prawns biryani is ready to serve hot.